sorry, my first decision, and now we're like new arena. This is good now.
This year, the two Newcastle Knights players were convicted in Newcastle Court for assault. Today, Judge Nader overturned that decision, finding Robin McCormack and Glenn Miller not guilty of attacking Stephen Anthes, a former Australian kickboxing champion.
Is a change in the way that the police are doing business. We recognise that victims have needs, and we have to cater for those needs.
The concept was brought to Newcastle by the NRMA, and is unique in the region. Only one other for victims' room exists in the country.
The NRMA did coordinate some of these in the Wollongong area, which would prove an enormous success. So I decided that we would try to introduce this to the police up here.
places that help she's received from vocal a support group for victims of crime. She's now on vocal committee and is lobbying the government for changes to the way victims of crime are treated. She'd like to see vocal and the police work together when a serious crime is committed. She believes is that the time in the victim's family it feels most alone. It's just too impersonal.
Heading for a conference in Canberra tomorrow. At the top of the agenda, their response to the latest government-initiated report called Into the Oil Industry. Australia's competition watchdog has recommended the federal government scrap the existing price controls on petrol, saying that it serves no useful purpose. Instead, the Australian Competition and Consumer Commission's recommended heightening competition of the four major oil companies to an increase in the number of independent fuel retailers. But the independents working
season's best performers both on and off the field. Rookie of the Year was Shane Lott from Broadmeadow. While Western's Keith Harris won the prize for his outstanding achievements as coach.
I get much more enjoyment out of the players and their improvement. And they're excited. But, yeah, personal award is good.
Harris was the standout after taking the Bears to the minor premiership undefeated. He hopes to cap off the season in this weekend's grand final.
That wouldn't be any better than the season.
A three-way tie for leading goal scorer, Ian Tressida, Danny Gordon and Brett McCool. Well, they each found the net 15 times, but the main award was the Player of the Year, and the winner, Warriors striker, Ben Lane. The 22-year-old accepting the award, but also on behalf of his teammates.
Great bunch of blokes and always full of support. Important that and any backing call that you've got, you know, they're always there.
The NBN Soccer League season winds up on Sunday, with the Western Highfields Grand Final.
Was indoors for Anthony Stewart. The 26-year-old from Charlestown warming out for a big season in the Sheffield Shield on fresh after his stint in Queensland in the new Super Brakes competition.
I was quite happy. They were bowled up there. You know, that was, you only got six.
It's the third time Stewart has padded up for New South Wales after the disappointing
opponents of last season. The Blues are planning to hit back. Greg Matthews has been sworn in as captain, whilst Stewart will be out to impress the national selectors.
Not looking any further than the season with New South Wales. Hopefully I'll consolidate the spot there and pick up a few more weeks than I did last year. And who knows what can happen.
The Shield season starts in November.
RSPCA raid on this Medowie property 10 months ago had shot many. There were cattle and camel carcasses, plus scores of gaunt animals, little more than living skeletons. Before Raymond Harris court today, Alan John James and Karen Lee and Moore, Magistrate Alan Railton told James he could not avoid his responsibilities. The magistrates said the animals had been totally dependent on him for their proper care. James was found guilty on two charges of aggravated cruelty. The court heard how Ms. Moore had tied a Kelpie dog to a stake with baling twine and shot him once in the head. She was found guilty on one case of aggravated cruelty. The court was told that the size of the property was clearly not sufficient to carry cattle without supplementary feeding. At the time of the raid, there had been no evidence of recent feeding. The magistrate will sentence the pair on October 8th. Peter Ryan, NBN News.
Season wasn't the greatest for the Breakers. Things are looking up. Three of their youngest players have been given the chance to wear the Soccer's international arena. Breakers players Peter Ritchie, Glenn Moore and Clay Pitten Zane were busy honing their skills today, preparing to trial for the Young Socceroos. 33 hopefuls will trial. The squad will then be narrowed to 18. All three are looking forward to the challenge.
Then play at the World Youth Cup in Malaysia next year. My daughter, Royal NBN News. Last season wasn't the greatest for the Breakers. Things are looking up.
three of their youngest players have been given the chance to wear the Soccer's international arena. Breakers players Peter Ritchie, Glenn Moore and Clayton Zane were busy honing their skills today, preparing to trial for the young Soccer Roots. 33 hopefuls will trial. The squad will then be narrowed to 18. All three are looking forward to the challenge.
The hard-working kid, the high school-year-old, Darren, hopefully looking at squad to the United States. Having seen a lot of the bikes over the season, I don't know what they've been up to, but I'm working hard and I'm not going to keep it on the really good chance. I've been waiting for this for a while now, and I'm relieved that I've been picked for it. Now I've got to really try hard and play well, and hopefully get picked. While at camp in Canberra, the trio's fitness and skill work will be tested. Trial games will decide the squad, but the young Socceroos will tour South America in October.
Ratepayers, business and residents, against rallying in an attempt to steer council from a course that seems to be leading towards the approval of the power markets. The proposed 1,000 stalls held aside is seen by business people as the major threat to retailing viability in the city, dragging an estimated $47 million out over 2 years. The council sees the proposal as a $30 million plus, bringing new jobs along with the proviso of the old co-op store site redevelopment. Lord Mayor Greg Heath, in Canada, sometimes hostile response from the 350-strong crowd. Finally promised to go back and check council's figures. Meanwhile, the proposal could come unstuck on a technicality, as yet the land is not zoned for such a development.
There was near of Castle at the Falcons train session this afternoon, sitting ninth just outside the top eight. The pressure is now on the Falcons to finish the season with a string of victories. A hand against South East Melbourne tomorrow, they had seen the magic get them falling against Illawarra for Hawks in the first, the double header clash tonight. The final quarter fight back and overtime mobile hall of the Gold Coast, as well as last week, and gave the Falcons a taste of what's needed to stay in finals contention.
Well, the intensity showing the last quarter during the overtime was good. The intensity to show over the 53-minute span of the ball game would be questionable, so we have to look at the sustaining intensity. Yes, that's something that we would look to improve on this week.
David Van Dyke proved to be the linchpin in that game, but Coach Tom Wiseman isn't playing favourites for the vital encounter ahead.
Students and staff have gathered at the University this afternoon to hear who the new Vice-Chancellor, Professor Roger Holmes, deliver his first public address in Newcastle. He was speaking on the future of the University, following when the federal government had funding cuts, which will see the University losing nearly $15 million over 3 years from its annual operating grants.
We're at the stage where we really need to plan and effectively forward, do the best thing we can for the University and the students, and then come forward with a plan for the next 3 years. The last supper of sorts today, as both camps set down for a grand final lunch at league headquarters. Come Sunday, the atmosphere won't be as calm, with both sides keen to take the premiership won by Curry for the last 3 years. West of Dunn,
dominated the season with a superior defensive record, conceding just 200 points in 16 matches. The Rizellas had a hard run last night. Injured hooker Tony Hutton watching from the sideline. Captain Tony Price says Hutton will be missed, but capably replaced by Paul Bowen.
He's a sort of player on the field who gets everyone fired up. When we sort of lead it, he's the one there that fires us up. So we're missing Paulie, but we've got adequate passion in Paul Bowen, who'll do the job.
Thanks also, Trey. Look at Goldberg with the Sun. Plays match with the Sun. The logical advantage. After narrowly defeating West in the major semi 2 weeks ago. The return from injury of lock Craig Hibbert will bolster the Sea Gulls ranks. Captain David Smith feels all confident.
We're pretty confident. We got into this game, first people into the grand final. We're feeling pretty confident.
Kickoff is at 3 p.m. The match to be televised on NBN at 11 p.m. on Monday.
Shout to the lads, Macy, thank you and far between, but often the work the volunteers goes unnoticed. This group brave the big day to deliver a shipment of blankets to the needy. As part of the wrap with love relief drive, about 20,000 people throughout Australia, and in blankets to send to war torn and impoverished places around the world. Using leftover wool stitched into squares, colourful blankets take shape. This load headed to the foggy highlands of Papua New Guinea.
We sent to the family of the slave, we sent 9,000. Our recent shipment went up to Vladivostok, where it gets to -40 to a hospital up there for seniors.
The warm wraps will be shipped north on a Christian ship when it leaves Newcastle in October, taking medical support, medical know-how and Christian ministry to the islands.
It is just so rewarding. I just say that there are thousands of caring human beings out there. We're just going to tap into them.
And Penrith are two of the newcomers in rugby union's double AMI Cup, and while they're both out of this year's finals chase, nothing will be given away tomorrow.
We're looking forward to finally when it's unlikely to stop them failing, because we'll be back in the competition at the same time.
Hoping to stretch their racing good run, the Wildfire have been working on lineouts, a lack of hide and starboard, the side of possession in the last three matches against Warringah, Manly and Gordon.
The real problem is we just don't have any real tall players, but that shouldn't be as great a problem against Penrith, because they have similar difficulties with their lineup.
The Wildfire season ends next weekend with the final round clash with Norths. It's a big weekend in soccer for the Newcastle Breakers, and the side build up their energy to that day with a special breakfast in Cox's Harbour. The Breakers play the whole four-day coast tomorrow, and Arden will fill the team mixed with youth and experience.
Kids that I have bought, the kids that will certainly be playing their youth game this year, and a couple of them will probably get a run in first round.
On Sunday, all first graders will line up for the Wildfire Cup match. Wildcard Oval. The Breakers made it NBN Soccer League grand final winners high fields. Jump, Knopfson, and NBN News. It's the grand final coming early for Newcastle, clinching to 8th position on the ladder. The Knights boarded for the game most of billing at the clash of the season.
It's going to be a whip. It's a whip round. They go terrifically in the whip ever since inside the kick. And that's the toughest stuff they're doing the whip, so it's going to be a tough one. But I think we're just a little bit more desperate.
A win will guarantee Newcastle for that last spot in the 8th. And while they'll do everything to get it, a win for the Sharks keeps alive their top four hopes. And the finals dreams of West, Auckland, the Tigers and Parramatta.
No, no. I mean, last game of the year, tomorrow night, it feels like the season's... I really just warm up. The semi's coming up.
Adding more spice to the matches, Cronulla. Memory of the last game between the clubs. Last year at the City Football Stadium, the Knights put an end to the Sharks' premiership the campaign with a thrilling 1-point victory. This year, the Sharks also lost the points, but through forfeit.
Now, I think it's going to be the hardest game of the year. So, you know, really, we're ready for the game, so, you know, I'm just looking forward to it. I think we'll get over it.
Tomorrow, guys, game on NBN at 8:30. Ciao. Johnson up to NBN News. Was in brutal forming, waking the Fox still cup. The 11 points can win over Brisbane, placing for coach top from Brisbane, but he traded for victory tomorrow.
We had the opportunity to then with the court time squad. We had the opportunity again next week. It's all about getting us ready to play on the first down.
At training this afternoon, learned the basket was getting another good work. Look out, so two niggling injuries. Scotty Ninnis is missing concerns about his wrist.
Yeah, no problem, sir. This race on yesterday, and
Newcastle host Canberra at the entertainment centre in desperate for a native win. The Falcons are about to put the cannons on the fire from the outset. It's 3 points score. Playing machine David Van Dyke.
We gotta have this one. They're one of the teams that's taking for the final five. So, we gotta come out and play a good ball for that. That's what we're doing.
Jonathan Upton, NBN News.